This review was prepared by Davit Marikyan and Savas Papagiannidis and published by TheoryHub. TheoryHub covers a wide range of theories and acts as a starting point for theory exploration in different research and teaching and learning contexts. This is a review of the Unified Theory of Acceptance and Use of Technology. The Unified Theory of Acceptance and Use of Technology was developed by Venkatesh and colleagues in 2003. It examines the acceptance of technology, determined by the effects of performance expectancy, effort expectancy, social influence, and facilitating conditions. The growth of an e-commerce sector, emerging digital technologies, such as big data, artificial intelligence, cloud computing, and robotics, drive the implementation of new technologies in organizations. Research community accelerated its interest towards technology acceptance in the private and organizational contexts almost three decades ago. By year 2000, technology acceptance research had resulted in a substantial body of evidence on user behavior related to technology adoption. Numerous theories had been introduced to understand the acceptance of the technology. They had roots in different disciplines, which limited the applications of these theories to certain contexts. Therefore, a unified approach was needed to embrace variables reflecting different perspective and disciplines and increase the applications of the theory to different contexts. To provide a holistic understanding of technology acceptance, Venkatesh and colleagues set the objective for developing a unified theory of technology acceptance by integrating key constructs predicting behavioral intention and use. To fulfill this objective, the seminal information systems acceptance literature was reviewed to draw up theoretical and contextual similarities and differences among technology acceptance theories originating from three research streams: social psychology, information systems management, and behavioral psychology. Given that the theories stem from different disciplines, they cast diverse perspectives on technology acceptance and adoption. The review of different theories led Venkatesh and colleagues to identify limitations, which in turn triggered the need to develop the unified theory of acceptance and use of technology. The primary limitation was that the literature had not empirically tested and compared dominant technology acceptance models, which left room for speculation on the predictive power of the constructs of each theory. The studies examining technology use behavior had mainly focused on simple systems and overlooked the use of more complex technologies. The focus on one technology constrains the explanatory power of theories, as individuals' experiences, purchase decisions, and use cases vary depending on information technology systems and contexts. Also, there were methodological limitations identified in prior literature. Most studies had used a cross-sectional approach by measuring variables at pre- or post-acceptance stages, although some constructs needed to be examined over time. The limitations suggested using a longitudinal approach to fully understand the dynamics of technology acceptance and use. Finally, previous studies had focused on the technology acceptance in a voluntary context, which put a constraint on the generalizability of the findings. Therefore, to ensure the wider implication of the models, technology acceptance was investigated both in mandatory and voluntary settings. The empirical comparison of the theories enabled authors to develop a unified acceptance model, which embraced and reflected all key acceptance factors. The theoretical model of unified theory of acceptance and use of technology suggests that the actual use of technology is determined by behavioral intention. The perceived likelihood of adopting the technology is dependent on the direct effect of four key constructs, namely performance expectancy, effort expectancy, social influence, and facilitating conditions. The effect of predictors is moderated by age, gender, experience, and voluntariness of use. Performance expectancy is defined as the degree to which individuals believe that using the system will help them attain gains in job performance. Effort expectancy is defined as the degree of ease associated with the use of the system. Social influence is defined as the degree to which an individual perceives that important others believe he or she should use the new system. Social influence is similar to the subjective norms, denote that the behavior of people is adjusted to the perception of others about them. Facilitating conditions refers to the degree to which an individual believes that an organization's and technical infrastructure exists to support the use of the system. Unified theory of acceptance and use of technology has made several contributions to the literature. The model provides empirical insight into technology acceptance by comparing prominent technology acceptance theories, which often offer competing or partial perspectives on the subject. Unified theory of acceptance and use of technology demonstrates that proposed factors account for 70% of the variance in use intention, offering stronger predictive power compared to the rest of the models that examine technology acceptance. Although the original unified theory of acceptance and use of technology framework was developed to explain and predict the acceptance of technology in an organizational context, later it was also tested in non-organizational settings. Over the years, unified theory of acceptance and use of technology showed wide application, which enhanced the generalizability of the theory. Given the variance of information communication technologies and the advances in the sector, a number of scholars extended unified theory of acceptance and use of technology to adapt it to the context or improve its predictive power. The first stream of research extended the model to apply it to new technologies, focus on new user segments, and examine it in new geographical and cultural settings. Another stream of research extended unified theory of acceptance and use of technology by incorporating additional endogenous variables, such as satisfaction and continuous intention to use. The third stream of research scrutinized additional determinants of use and behavioral intention, such as task technology fit and personality traits. Finally, some studies extended unified theory of acceptance and use of technology by introducing new contextual and moderating variables, such as culture, ethnicity, religion, employment, language, income, education, and geographical location, among others. Although the adaptations of the model enriched the understanding of the theory applications, the research was mainly limited to organizational settings. The literature lacked evidence about a user behavioral model, which could explain the utilization of technology by consumers rather than employees. However, such evidence was important, given arguments in prior studies suggesting that the determinants of acceptance in organizational and non-organizational settings are not the same. It was found that the importance of the factors reflecting the costs and benefits of behavior varied based on the context. Given the above limitations, Venkatesh and colleagues proposed an extension of unified theory of acceptance and use of technology. The extended version of the model set out to address two main objectives. First, compared to all prior attempts to extend the model, unified theory of acceptance and use of technology 2 was not designed to have a specific focus. Instead, the goal of the theory was to represent an overarching framework for examining technology acceptance. The extension was designed to give a higher precision in explaining user behavior. The second objective was to propose a behavioral model of consumer technology acceptance, in contrast to unified theory of acceptance and use of technology, which was developed to examine technology in organizational settings. To fulfill the objective, Venkatesh and colleagues plan to extend the unified theory of acceptance and use of technology model with new constructs, tackling behavioral and attitudinal determinants of the utilization of technology in the non-organizational context. The authors updated the theory by introducing three new constructs and altering some relationships in the original model to adapt it to the consumer technology use context. Such an approach offered a new theoretically justified mechanism for predicting technology acceptance, which was encouraged and endorsed by prior research. In addition to advancing the technology acceptance literature, Unified Theory of Acceptance and Use of Technology 2 aimed to achieve wider generalizability by addressing the private user segment. Unified Theory of Acceptance and Use of Technology 2 postulates that the use of technology by individuals is underpinned by the effect of the three additional constructs, namely hedonic motive, perceived value and habit, moderated by age, gender, and experience. Hedonic motivation is defined as the fun or pleasure derived from using technology. Perceived value is defined as consumers' trade-off between the perceived benefits of the applications and the monetary cost for using them. The third variable is habit, which is defined as the extent to which people tend to perform behaviors automatically. The extended version of unified theory of acceptance and use of technology resulted in a number of theoretical contributions. The model explained 74% of the variance in behavioral intention and 52% of the variance in technology use, which suggests that the model has high predictive validity when applied to the consumer segment. The supported effects of price value, hedonic motivation, and habit indicate three significant drivers of consumers' intention to use or actual use of technology. Thank you for listening. To download the full review or to read other theory reviews, visit open.ncl.ac.uk.